Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Guitar of the Day. I'm your host, Michael Lemo. It is so stressful today.
Oh my gosh.
We're all going crazy. Stir crazy. I think we deserve it, finally. It's about time the Norms crew goes go wild. Jen's going to kill me.
Yes.
I'm going to kill Brandon.
Yes.
Norms.
I'm going to kill everybody.
Kill everybody. But it's okay. It's okay. It's stressful because we're only here 2 days a week right now. And obviously we have a lot of the Christmas orders coming in too. And so we got a lot to do in 2 days. But we're still so, we love that you guys are supporting us and everything. But it's just been insane. So we'll get it together. We got this. We're all still friends. She didn't say yeah though.
I did it.
She just laughed.
I did.
For the record, she didn't say yeah. Okay. Oh my gosh. Well, we have a cool guitar today. It's a little different. Yeah,
I'm excited.
Let's check it out. Yeah, it's pretty cool. So this was introduced at NAMM in 1980, and it's a 1980 Fender The Strat.
Ooh.
Ace metallic blue with gold parts and a maple neck.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah,
this and is headstock.
Matching headstock.
Yes.
And just a Strat. Headstock's pretty cool too. It's kind of the pre-CBS smaller headstock, back to kind of the more stealthy look. But yeah, you got that matching headstock with the gold parts. You also have another option on this toggle back here, where you can multiply to almost 9 positions. Now we're not gonna do 9 songs, but
wait.
I know. If the day couldn't get any better. Gosh. We're gonna do 9 songs.
No, we're not.
What's up, Nick?
It could get better, Mike.
What do you got?
Michael bet me $20 and Jen bet me $20 that I wouldn't rub my butt on this guitar live on camera.
Oh, you wouldn't do that.
Oh, no, there's your $20.
Whoa!
There's yours.
Day's getting better, baby.
Oh, woo! My God. Juicy
Can
butts.
Can I get this guitar for $20?
No.
Cool. Okay, that makes sense. All right, we got a maple neck, like I said. Really thin neck. Really kind of strange because the guitar is really heavy. And then you have this thin neck. It's kind of an interesting dynamic, but still, a really cool guitar, plays great. Got that gold plaque too with that little Fender sign, which is really cool.
I love the gold, though.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie.
And it's got this hot lead pickup, which is branded as the X1 at the time, and it's a 5-way selector. And like I said, this just gives you a couple more options. We might cover them, we might not. But this was designed by Greg Wilson with the help of Dan Armstrong. This is that time period. And like I said, just a really cool guitar. Definitely a heavier one. But, you know, some people don't mind that. And I don't. I think it sounds great. So we're going to take it out front. It's the original case. Let me see if we got any. Nothing too crazy.
And the song. The song that's out on iTunes.
Ooh.
Yeah, so
you
what are you going to say
about
it? You
guys
got to
check out the song. The year that never was.
Which is this year.
This year. Unfortunately, it did happen this year. It was just absolutely terrible. I want to change the title to The Year That I Wish Never Happened. No. But we did do a song. Norm wrote it called The Year That Never Was. Of course, about 2020. And I was able to play on it. I played the Jaguar that Susan got me, which is really cool. Josh Smith produced it, Brandon played on it, and Grant Geisman, and then last but not least, Joe Bonamassa. And there's a great little section in the end where Norm kind of talks to him. He says, hey, can we put any more, what does he say, guitars on this turkey? And Joe goes, yeah, I think so, or something. But you got to check it out. It's really cool. And the most important thing is we had some fun, and it's really cool. I always want to kind of tell Norm that he really should be writing music, playing his organ, playing the bass. Norm,
he doesn't want to.
I know. It's almost like to the point where it's like, maybe I won't ask him because he really gets upset. But everybody else likes it.
I mean,
it's the weirdest thing.
Every time we say, he
really
you sound
gets down.
Really
so
good.
In the comment section of The Year That Never Was, go wild. Just go crazy.
Say, every time we give positive feedback, he doesn't like it.
Yeah, he thinks you're lying.
Yeah. I'm like,
he thinks we're lying.
He thinks
we're like, Norm, you're doing great. You're a liar. You're fired. No, it's not that far. But it's really cool, and it's got some great changes, and Norm really does know his music. And one of the coolest things about Norm is not only the guitars he carries, but he's got a great ear. You know, they know it when they hear it, and it's always soulful and to the point. And I think that his music is the same way. So check it out. It's a really cool song.
Available everywhere.
Yeah, it's available everywhere. I think even Spotify.
Yeah, iTunes. And proceeds go to the
Midnight Mission.
Yes.
Which is very, very cool. God, I mean, sometimes, you know, you have to ask yourself in a year like this, how bad can it get? But there's people who have it worse, and this song's going to help those people. So it's a really cool thing. And like I said, Norm wrote the lyrics, wrote the melody.
We sang on it.
We sang on it. We played guitar on it. And we had a lot of fun, most importantly. So check it out. And thank you guys so much. We're going to take this out front. And hope you enjoy. Let's do it. Happy Saturday.
Nine positions.
Nine songs. This episode will be an hour, so put a pizza in the oven.
They would actually love that. Don't say that.
Yeah, okay. All right, we're out front with the 1980 Fender The Strat. Whoa. They just stop it right there. In ice metallic blue, really cool guitar. Definitely heavier, like we covered in the back, but really something different. We're also going through a 1960s Fender Twin Reverb. We're gonna start off clean and see what we get. Let's check it out. Starting off with that neck pickup. Thank you. middle and bridge. We're just going into middle. I'm sorry about that. And we're gonna turn on a little overdrive and do some Clapton. Let's check it out. Middle and bridge. Oh my gosh, we're all over the place today. All right, we're gonna turn it up a little bit and do a little crossfire. Thank you. It's a 1980 Fender The Strat. Can even do some more things, but we can only cover so much. But it's a really cool guitar and a lot of options. Check out these guitars at normansrareguitars.com and also on Instagram and Facebook. I'm your host, Michael Lemo. We'll see you very soon, and thank you so much for watching. And, yeah, we love you guys.
Bye.